Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTV UK with the mystical Paul Hindmarsh from Line 6. How's it going, sir? Mystical? Well, you are a mystical entity, aren't you? You know everything about everything Line 6, and you want a hell of a player.
I quite like that.
You having a good show so far?
Yeah, well, it's very early. It's the first sort of the first morning, so I haven't done any stage demos yet. But
we've got you at the best now, though, as well, instead of last thing on a Sunday.
Yeah, probably, yeah. But I'll probably have a better idea what I'm talking about on Sunday.
And what you're talking about is the new Line 6 Pod Go.
Indeed.
Which looks amazing.
Yeah, so we just released this about an hour ago. Mm-hmm. Essentially, it's the pod has been out now for, believe it or not, like 22 years. The first pod came out in 1998. And obviously, there's been so many different incarnations from then. You know, like mm-hmm. we went through all these different types, and I've pretty much owned every single one of them. Mm-hmm. So it's always important that the pod name should continue. And then this is the latest step, the latest version of this. Mm-hmm. So on this, the most important thing, I guess, is really all the modeling's been updated. So it's all HX models now.
Okay.
So they've all been taken from the rest of the HX user processes that we have.
I mean, people have just been waiting for this after the years of the Helix. It's like, new pod. There's going to be a new pod soon, and now it's finally here.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's got 270 sounds from the HX user modelers in there. We've adopted a bunch of other things, which we've been adopting for quite a while on all products, which is the color-coded foot switch. So we have color-coded LED foot switches, which will change. So we all know that green's going to be delay, orange is going to be like an overdrive, you know, like a blue there is going to be a modulation. So
anyone that's even slightly familiar with Line 6 have it ingrained in them that these colors mean that.
Absolutely, yeah. It's almost like a language now, isn't it,
exactly.
for having those effects like that. And then obviously got a bigger LCD screen there as well. Everything's color coded in there also. The rotary encoders underneath there as well. So there's very little going through menus and going through pages. Mm-hmm. Everything that you see on the screen, if you're in edit view, you're actually going to be able to edit those sounds that get jumping directly to those parameters at the bottom.
Yes.
You know, so it's just things that we've been rolling out over the last few years that people have really, really enjoyed and stuff. And so we've put them on Pod Go as well. But most important thing really is the update of all the models, you know, that's the main thing. Oh, we've got snapshots in there as well. So snapshots is a...
Oh, you weren't telling me that before. Snapshots are in this as well.
Yeah, so snapshots is a great feature. Yeah, so we have snapshots there. So you've got obviously your stomp pedal mode, which is where you would just use it like a normal like floorboard where you're switching your effects in and out. Then you have your play view. And play view, if I just go into here... Although the camera's not on the top of there, so I don't necessarily need it to. So you have play view where that's all your presets, and that's where you travel through all your presets and everything. Stomp view where you've got all your pedals, and then if you press these two pedals together, you end up in snapshots view. And for anybody who's not familiar with snapshots, that's where you have four different variations of each preset sitting within the same preset.
It's like presets within a preset.
Absolutely, yeah. So it means that once I'm in snapshot view, I've got A, B, C, D. Number like A could be the rhythm sound using a JTM amplifier. Mm-hmm. Snapshot number two could be that same amplifier but with the gain turned up, mm-hmm. maybe a bit extra reverb added to it, maybe a bit extra delay, maybe a bit less treble. Mm-hmm. And it's seamless when you do that. There's no latency of moving from preset to preset. Mm-hmm. So it's instant being able to do that.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Most importantly though, can we have a listen to it?
Yeah, so this is like a JTM patch that I sort of quickly sort of got together before. Your JTM sound.
Mm-hmm. As everything, because this is like HX sounds, isn't it, essentially?
Yeah, yeah.
It's very familiar with the proper amp it's replicating.
Yeah.
It just sounds so, so good.
Yeah, so it's all the component modeling that we've been using.
That's the word I was trying to think of.
Yeah, so it's very dynamic to how you pick if you just play along.
The direct signal from the pod, which is also a way you can use it live. We're hearing it through the little mic, the cab here,
yep.
Power cab, but live you would use this the same way you would another kind of modeler, just straight into the PA essentially, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So, and yeah, we've got some interesting things on the back of there. I mean, in terms of I/O, it's very, the idea with this unit is it's very plug and play. You just plug in, you get the sounds that you want. In terms of edit, in terms of the editing process on there as well, probably we should say is you can have 9 different blocks in the signal path. They're all preloaded, so each preset will always have an amplifier, will always have a cabinet model or an impulse response. Mm-hmm. There's a volume, a wah, and an EQ in there. And then the last sort of remaining 4 blocks, they're the ones that you can actually go and tweak yourself. And that's where you choose whether you want delays, reverbs, different types of distortions as well. So it's, not a lot of menus. Get straight in there with HX sort of. HX sort of models and yeah, plug and play is a good is a good phrase for that. A few more little sounds.
If you could, yeah, Paul, that'd be amazing.
Yeah, so what I've got here is I've set up some snapshots with different effects. So this is the Uber. Same thing with a double track on there.
Double track sounds great.
Yeah, it does. It's just kind of really cool. It's just like a little bit of a delay, but it sort of moves around a little bit like you're playing, like you're playing with another guitar player. And then as I move through some more of these sounds. Maybe some things like this. I'll get yourself back up in there. So snapshot number B is a drier sound. All the wet sound. Big reverbs that we released a little while ago as well, like all the big searchlights reverbs and things.
Yeah, very, very nice. Well, it looks super simple to use. It sounds fantastic. Yeah. And thank you so much for taking time out of your day to show me.
No problem at all. Always a pleasure to see another Geordie over in the States.
Hell yeah, Paul. Nice one. Cheers.
Cheers.